Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing a little mini guide on urns and free to play because I didn't know anything about them, and then I just found out from a friend. So if you're not free to play, and if you are free to play and know about urns, then you might as well just turn this video off because it's not for you. But if you're free to play and don't know about urns, then watch this video, I guess. Okay, so basically, I'm going to be doing it with cooking urns because that's what I'm training, cooking. And basically how it works is you need 36 crafting for cooking urns, but if you want to make up to wood cutting urns, then you need 44 crafting. But I recommend these are the only ones you can go up to, the normal ones, and I recommend getting the levels for them because cracked and fragile urns aren't really worth the XP, and it only takes a few minutes to get up to that level anyway. So basically how you get them, I recommend buying them on the Grand Exchange, but instead of buying them, you can't buy these ones. You can't buy these ones on the Grand Exchange. You can only buy the NR ones, and you can also only buy 200 an hour. So what I recommend buying is however many you want to buy, and then however many you want to buy the same amount of fire rooms. And then basically what you do is rank all your stuff. This is how I find it effective. Use a fire rune on it and then press make all, and it does it automatically. And that's all you gotta do to make them. What it does is it fills the urns with scraps from cooking. Right, so if I use a lobster on this fire, no idea why it didn't work there, but anyway, so then when you've got a full urn from cooking, it takes about two inventories to fill a whole urn. And then what you do is you teleport it, and if you put this on custom, it shows it as a magic thing, but it doesn't give you any magic XP at all, so just teleport it away. And as you can see, I got 950 XP. It's not that much, but it helps, and I've used over about 40 urns, so in a day, that is, in about 5 hours. And that's 40k XP just for sticking it in my inventory and using them, I guess. So I'll show you the method on how you want to use them. Also, there's three types. These ones where there's nothing in it, them ones where they've already been started and there's something in them. Also, you can check the level. And it's 2 XP per every food. I'm not sure if that's correct, but on tuna and lobster, it's 2% rather on every food. So yeah, I'll go to Algrid and I'll be back when I get there. Whee! Okay, so you're gonna wanna use the Algrid spot to do this, and just use your lobsters on the range, obviously. And it'll come up in a minute. your urn is a quarter full or something, and if it is less than half full, then you don't need to take out another urn. But if it's over half, then you should. There it is. Then you take out another urn, so you still get the same amount of XP. And if you don't understand what I just said, then you'll see in a minute. I'll pause it until the inventory's finished. Okay, so we're done. And just drop the burnt lobsters if you don't want them. Right, so it's almost 3/4 full, so you're gonna wanna pull out another urn and raw food. Do the same thing. Yeah, three quarters full now. And it, when it gets to full, you're gonna wanna wait until you get to the bank. Good. Well, this is if you want to do it the fastest way. Alright, so your cooking urn is full. Start a new urn. So you start on this urn. And this is what I mean, because if you only have this one in still, you wouldn't get any percentage up on that. So it's always best to have two if it's under half. If it's over half, if. Right, let me start again. It's always best to have two if it's over half, and if it's under half like this one will be, then just have one. So when you get to the bank, you're gonna wanna teleport your urn and bank. Right, so you see this one isn't over half full, so you don't need to get another one out. So yeah. Right, well, I know this guy was a bit crap, but I'm gonna try and make him better as I make more videos and try and like just make better guides, I suppose. So if you liked it, then I like it, I guess. And if you didn't like it, then just put some constructive criticism in the comment section. Alright, cheers, see you later.